Hey everyone, this is Zero. So, a while back we made a post asking about what kind of content you guys want to see. And the most common request we got was how to play with a poor opening hand. So today I got some tips to help you do a rough game and still get that win. Alright, so everyone who has played this game know that you want to start with rookies, digivolve up, draw some cards, and then start your game plan. But this doesn't always happen. As with all card games, you will not get an ideal opening hand every single game. So here are some steps that you can take when things just doesn't quite go your way. First off, you might need to play your higher level Digimon directly so you can start digivolving and cycling for your rookies, or even just reach your level 6 and 7 this way. Now do be mindful of the type of decks you're playing against and understand what kind of cards that they have access to, along with all of the potential punish that could come with this. Since you're already behind from a slow start, you cannot give your opponent high value plays. Now, what I mean by this is you might want to avoid playing multiple 4000 power or less Digimon if you're playing into a deck that you suspect might run Volcanodramon. Also, you might not want to attack randomly and give your opponent free security checks, because one of those effects could completely shift the tempo of the game. I need to stress that your only goal here is to catch up and stabilize. Now, in some cases, you might want to do the opposite and try to take some risks and end the game faster. Because with the release of set 1.5, we will see decks such as O4 Sveitromon, Shine Greymon, and Ragnaloremon that focuses on setting up their combo pieces and then win the game in one big play. The other main method to mitigate a bad opening hand is simply just build your deck better. Now you might be asking, what do I mean by build a better deck? Well, for starter, you could be playing more Digimon with strong on-play effects so you can get value out of having to hard play them. Cards such as Magna Angemon and Zudomon will get you card advantage for playing them, while also opening a path to evolve into Mega. Alternatively, you could be playing Digimon with lower play costs. Cards such as Groundramon and Munzeemon are low power for their level 5, but their 5 play cost is comparable or lower than the average level 4 play cost. These type of Digimon are actually very popular with the type of decks that want to get to their high level Digimon very quickly. Finally, you could and should probably be playing more rookies. In our first deck building video, we mentioned that the minimum amount of rookies that you should be playing is 12. And we seriously do mean minimum, because realistically that number is still very low and will significantly increase the risk of you not opening a rookie in your opening hand. You will find that most competitive lists will on average run 15 to 16 rookies, and in some cases like Rookie Rush, a lot more. So with all that said, let's do some closing thoughts. Now, I personally feel that one very good aspect of the Digimon TCG is that most bad hands are actually still fairly playable, outside of the very rare cases where you open all your levels 6 and 7. But what can you do? It's a card game. And while I know that the lack of mulligan can be very frustrating, but let me assure you that it's very possible to win games where you don't open your rookie to start. I myself have done it plenty of time, and I playtest this game hundreds of times. Also, as we get Digimon with better effect, this becomes less of an issue. Something as simple as more level 4 that give you effects for playing them directly will have significant positive impacts on the game. This game is surprisingly deep. There are quite a few number of decision trees, all with different opportunity costs and benefits. So just keep practicing and do the play that you think is best. And that's all I have for you today. Thank you very much for watching.